Make these fat asses fly.
Spiking bits.
Welcome back, Hobby Maniacs. I'm Rob Bear from SpikyBits.com, and we got another future-proofing video for you today. So I've talked about magnet bearing stuff in the past. It has great flight stands with magnets, great options to pick up a bunch of magnets all at once. In a lot of cases, if not the same price or cheaper than Amazon, which is kind of crazy once you start thinking about it. And it's super easy to work with, and he's at all the shows, you know? So super dope guy. He's gonna change the hobby world. I've been saying that for years now, and I think it's actually starting to happen. Fast forward to now, Games Workshop has put out some of the suppressor minis, and you know, I guess Caradon Overlords too, but and they're gonna be a thing now here in the near future. And they have these really fiddly stands, and I think you know exactly which ones I'm talking about. But they're terrible, let's be honest. But Magnet Baron makes some flying stands that are a little too thick, and some people don't like them because they're a little too thick. I've used them on my miniatures, my Inceptors, and my Custodi Jet Bikes. You've probably seen them in the past when we did some tutorials. So today, what I'm gonna do is show you how to work out your hobby muscles on those little small, very thin, and fiddly flight stands for your models like suppressors and Caradon Overlords, or even any jetpack troops, to kind of keep the size and the height true, but still also keep them from breaking off every 5 seconds as well. So let's jump over to Magnet Baron's site and show you what you're gonna need to stock up on, because it isn't a kit, it's just something you're gonna need to scoop up, and I'll show you exactly how to hobby on it. So here's the site, it's just magnetbaron.com. You can browse for flying stands. There's a bunch on here, believe me, you won't believe there's like 12 pages of them. Whoops, let's go back. There's like 12 pages of it's crazy. But you're gonna wanna look for these. And if you like the larger, kind of chunkier style with the little rock thing at the bottom, which are great for Inceptors, then you're done. Just buy this and good to go. You really don't have to do a whole lot of hobbying, just gluing magnets on and things like that. But if you want that true look and that true height for things like suppressors or even the Inceptors, because they use the same stands, and I think now the Custodi jump bikes or jump troops as well, then you're probably gonna wanna do something a little different. So first off, pick you up a pack of these 100 pack of these 1/8 inch by 1/16 inch disc magnets. These are N52 polarization or strength. They're super good magnets. And it's actually really, really hard to find these. I needed them in a day one time, and I couldn't find any on Amazon. It's crazy. So I had to make do. I had to wait an extra day, and it was rough because I needed it now. So don't run out of magnets. But with 100 of them, you're gonna be good for a very long time. And at $9.99, I don't feel like it's too bad. And I'm gonna show you a little bit of a hobby hack too with a new product they came out with over at Magnet Baron, and that's these pre-magnetized bevel bases. And you're probably like, I don't need that, I already have bases. And yes, I 100% agree with you too, but I'm gonna show you why you might wanna think about picking up a couple packs of these just for hobbying, not necessarily painting, but just the hobbying part of your miniatures. So here's one of the project boxes I've showed you in the past. This is just a plastic shoe box is what they call them. You can get a 10 pack from Amazon. I think we got some links below exactly where to scoop these up, or you can get them at Walmart, you know, any of your local stores. They're pretty easy to find. The tin, I've showed you this before as well. It's just held in with double-sided tape. And then also I started adding in a little bit of duct tape around the corners just to give it a double kind of a fail-safe rate of not popping out, and then your things go all over the place. But the reason I liked those magnet bases that I just showed you is for working on my miniatures, right? So in between painting them, because usually I paint the bases separate, so I'm gonna airbrush the bases separate and have them set off. They might get done before these guys, they might get done after these guys, but in between, they need bases, right? So why not use some of the magnetized bases right there? They fit right into the tin, super easy. I could put them in my little project boxes, and because this whole thing's about magnetizing suppressors, well, those guys are good to go in there as well. So everything just works out great.
once you start with a good solid foundation of those pre-magnetized bevel bases from MagnaBaron.
So step one is to get your suppressors together, and then you're gonna wanna cut off the little nub on the back where the flying stand attaches. It's a little round kind of nub, you'll see it right here. So just shave it flat and then grab your 1/8 inch drill bit, or I guess that's what, 3 millimeters or something, in the metric, and just drill straight up into the backpack. It doesn't matter which version of the suppressor you have, because some of them are at a different angle. You're gonna wanna drill all of them straight up into the backpack, just like this. Then take all of your flying stands and glue them down to those pre-magnetized bases, or the bases that you're gonna use for your project. What you're gonna wanna do next is cut the little stem across completely flush. So this is why it was important to cut straight up into the backpack. You don't want to cut completely across flush on the little flying stand right here. And then there'll actually be a gap in the middle. It's really hard to see because it's filled in with glue, but there will be a slight bit of gap, which is going to be nice, because put some glue on there, figure out your polarization, which way you're gonna wanna go, and stick with it, and then you're gonna wanna glue a little stack of 1/8 inch magnets on the very top here. And the glue is gonna spill out a little bit, it's gonna go around the sides, which is no big deal, because it actually starts to form a stronger bond. And you can see here, if you put a little bit more glue, it will actually kind of make this little layer, this little fillet, so to speak, around the bottom of the magnet, which is good. You wanna make sure you wait for this to completely dry before you move on. Once you go through all of the bases that you're going to use, it may be 3, it might be 6, it might even be 9, who knows? Then you can start on your actual miniatures themselves. So you've got the little holes already pre-drilled. You're gonna wanna stick one of the magnets up in there, make sure to check your polarizations, and just glue that in as well. Repeat the cycle, starting with the last one going backwards that you had completed, so hopefully the most dry. And what you're gonna wanna do is add a little bit of Vallejo plastic putty up on top here, because there's gonna be a little bit of a rough area. Maybe you could use a couple of magnets if you wanted to, but there's still gonna be a little bit of a gap, which will be super easy to fill in with Vallejo plastic putty. You could use green stuff if you wanted to. I love the plastic putty, it's super easy to work with. And just kind of fill that in and let it sit. And while all this is drying, we're gonna switch back to the stems. So here's the bottle of Vallejo plastic putty. It comes in like a toothpaste style tube, or you can actually get a dropper bottle. It's very similar to the paints themselves. We'll have the links below in the comments and the description for you to check those out. They're only like 5 or 8 bucks, give or take. So what you're gonna wanna do is take some of that putty right there, and you're gonna wanna slather it all around the sides of the magnet and then down the stem itself as well. So what that'll do is actually create strength for this whole interface here, which is really, really crucial, because this is just a magnet on top of a plastic stem. So you can't penetrate the magnet. So you have to almost create a cocoon of strength around it. And that's what we're doing right here. So again, you're gonna have to wait for this to dry. So go through the cycle of all your bases. You can use small fans, what have you, but make sure all of this is dry right here, and all of this is dry on your suppressors before we go on to the next step. Once everything's dry, you can risk, well, it's probably not a risk at that point, but you can actually check all your polarities and make sure that you mated them up just good. And as you can see here in this particular pose, it stacks up great. And I have one in my hand right here that I'm gonna show you live, the completed version of this. I just did all of this in my free time, so I snapped some pictures, because sometimes you just have to unplug. Speaking of finished products, here it is right here. So here's our suppressor and our magnetized base. You can see the magnet chilling up in there, and it's more than strong enough to hold all of this guy down right here. Flipping it over, you can see the finished plastic putty all over the stem, and then also on the backpack somewhat right there. And I mean, this is pretty strong. Like, I'm shaking this dude and he is not bobbleheading. He is super good to go. I mean, sometimes he kind of slides a little bit, but that's no big deal. So here's the plastic putty. And again, it's 5-8 bucks. I don't know. It just kind of depends on where you get it from. If you have a leak or anything, you can always just duct tape it up. This has literally lasted me like 5 years. It's crazy. I've had it forever. So I'm just gonna take some very, very high grit sandpaper here. You could use, this is 400, I probably need something, probably need more around 600, but I just don't have anything handy. And I don't wanna use
that a little toothbrush sander on this because I just don't want it to be too forceful and break that off. So I'm just gonna gently kind of, you know, sand down the surface right here and try not to breathe any of this crap in because that can't be good for you. And just go about that a little bit and then come over to here and the same thing as well, just kind of get in there and into some of the areas just to sand it down nice and flush so that it will receive paint and not be all like notchy and noticeable, so to speak, right there. And it's pretty much already there. So that was super easy. The key here is to give it enough time to dry and finish up right there. So I'm gonna do a lot more work to these. I've got some Iron Warriors bits from Pop Goes the Monkey and some other fun stuff. I'm gonna trick these guys out. But step one, build a solid foundation. And that's what we did right here with this base and then this magnetization. And now with the little carrying work in progress project box, I can just bebop them wherever and say I don't feel like painting. Well, I'm gonna hobby on my suppressors right here. So super easy to get them together and get them all mounted up. But perhaps the best thing about all this is that when it's time to pop them off and put them on their finished bases, I still have these resin magnetized bases and I can use them on the next project. So I don't have to keep buying these bases over and over if I don't want to. I just simply save them for the inevitable next project. So that's it for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Head over to Magnet Baron, scoop up your pre-magnetized bases and also whatever size bases you might need for your project. He has flying stands, he has all sorts of great stuff over there. But if this tickles your hobby pickle and you want to keep the nice little stem right here, it might require you to work out your hobby muscles, but I feel like future-proofing your little suppressors right here is, you know, very, very advantageous for a lot of different reasons out there. So hit on Magnet Baron, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications so you can be the very first to like and comment on all our videos.